It's going to be a tough back to school on Wednesday for students of Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida, where a gunman killed 17 students and staff earlier this year. They'll be returning to a new school year with some tighter security measures, but some parents and students fear it may not be enough to stop future tragedy. Officials at the school have brought on 18 campus security officers, including 3 uniformed sheriff's deputies, and the school's 3,200 students will now funnel through just 3 entrances when they arrive at the sprawling campus. Superintendent Robert Runcy gave the media a tour earlier this month, highlighting the changes, including new gates and fences that try to close off the campus.
Fencing there, so you can't get to that part. You can't get to that parking lot.
But the school opted against requiring students to use see-through backpacks or installing metal detectors, finding that it would be too difficult to screen all students each morning before class. Some parents have complained about the school board saying more should be done. Tony Montalto's daughter died in the shooting in February.
The constant reversals of policy positions continue to leave our county's students and teachers at risk.
The third deadliest shooting by a single gunman at a U.S. school inflamed the nation's long-running debate on gun rights and sparked a youth-led gun control movement. The U.S. House of Representatives took no steps to tighten gun laws after the massacre, but approved more spending for security measures.